Moro num país tropical, abençoado por Deus e bonito por natureza.
This is the story of a country whose music has seduced the outside world and taken on an importance that goes far beyond entertainment.
You want to learn about Brazilian history without going through the books. You can just listen to the music and you understand everything.
Brazilian music is having an enormous impact. Brazilian music. Ah.
Então acho que não é só para mim, acho que para todo brasileiro a música tem uma mistura muito grande, futebol e música, eu acho que é uma coisa que está dentro dos brasileiros.
E bonito por natureza. Tenho um fusca e um violão. Sou flamengo, tenho uma nega chamada Teresa.
In Brazil, music is a national passion. Wildly varied styles, from bossa nova to distinctively Brazilian forms of reggae and hip-hop, have projected rival views of how the country should see itself and be regarded abroad, while politicians have used music to try to bring unity to the largest state in South America. This is a story in which leading musicians are censored and jailed, and a one-time rebel, Gilberto Gil, becomes Brazil's first black government minister. And it starts with the music that dominates and defines this vast, multiracial state, samba. Samba is the best-known, most enduring style in Brazil. It's the samba rhythm that provides the backdrop for the spectacular Rio Carnival and for sophisticated dance songs that have helped to bring Brazil the exotic image it enjoys around the world. But samba also includes laments about life in the shanty towns, the favelas, and songs that address the recurring themes of race and poverty in a society that prides itself on being a racial democracy, but where the most black are often the most poor. Samba was born along the northeastern coast, around the city of Salvador back in the days of slavery. Salvador in Bahia State was the first capital of Brazil when it was colonized by the Portuguese in the 16th century. The indigenous tribes who lived along the coast were mostly killed, either by the Portuguese or by the diseases they brought from Europe. They were replaced by slaves who were transported from Africa to work in the plantations. Over the next 300 years, an estimated 4 million Africans were forcibly moved to Brazil. It was the largest slave population in the world, and Salvador was the main slave port.
O que tem de especial na Bahia é que a Bahia é um celeiro musical muito grande. A Bahia tem muita poesia, né?
Aqui começa o Brasil, né? E talvez pelo fato de tantas misturas, tantas etnias se encontrarem, houve um fusionismo natural e que se transformou em algo mais forte que a miscigenação dos homens.
Salvador is still a predominantly black city.
Eles vieram para aqui como escravos, como no tempo da escravidão, e aqui eles deixaram as culturas africanas, como o candomblé, né, como o samba e a música.
The samba rhythm developed from percussion styles used in candomblé an African-influenced religion which was banned in the slave era. In candomblé ceremonies, drummers call down different gods, or orishas, who are said to act as guides and guardians for the believers.
Exu é o orixá da sexualidade. Por isso mesmo, ele foi associado ao demônio. Oxum é a deusa do amor, a mulher vaidosa, coquete, cheia de dengos, que consegue as coisas através dos artifícios femininos. Este é Xangô, o orixá da justiça, da sabedoria, o orixá rico, protetor dos advogados.
This is a religion that evolved from deception. Slaves worshipped African gods while pretending that they were praying to the Catholic saints of the Portuguese. African beliefs and Catholicism began to mix, but the African rhythms used in candomblé didn't change.
O ritmo que é mais parecido no candomblé com o samba seria ritmo utilizado para Iansã, né? É que o Gan dirige dessa forma.
Samba takes its name from the African Angolan style Semba, which in Bahia was transformed by the slaves into a circle dance that was known as Samba de Roda or Samba de Chula.
O samba, esta palavra tão bonita, o samba, nasceu na Bahia. E sabe por que o samba nasceu na Bahia? Porque o Brasil nasceu na Bahia. E quem trouxe esse samba foi os negros. Cantando samba na senzala, samba de roda. O samba para mim é Deus. Deus é o samba. Deus é a música. A música é o samba. Se não estivesse realmente este samba, eu não sei do que seria de mim. Ah, eu vou cantar para vocês. Eu vou falar na Praça 15 de Novembro e na Praça Anchieta, que está no mesmo lugar. Aonde está nosso terreiro, se forma o samba brasileiro, que vai até o sol raiar. Oh, eu vou falar na Praça 15.
In 1888, Brazil became the last major country in the world to officially abolish slavery, 66 years after breaking away from Portugal to become an independent state. Black workers were at last free to leave the plantations. Many headed south to Rio de Janeiro, now the Brazilian capital. In Rio, the African rhythms of the former slaves mixed with European musical styles to create the different forms of modern-day samba.
Amor não é fácil de achar. A marca dos meus desenganos ficou, ficou. Só amor pode apagar. A marca dos meus desenganos ficou, ficou. Só amor pode apagar.
Muitas vieram para o Rio de Janeiro e trouxeram essa manifestação que é a gente, que é essa forma de samba, assim, que poderíamos chamar de mais primitiva, uma coisa mais de raiz, né? Que era uma chula, né? Onde se dançava, onde se criava uma roda e as pessoas dançavam, cantavam, improvisavam. E isso foi o embrião aqui no Rio de Janeiro, para a formação de grupos que depois se transformaram em escolas de samba.
O samba trazendo alvorada, meu coração conquistou.
everybody came from everywhere else in the country to live here. So even if the original beats of samba may have come from Bahia, from Africa, and such, Rio, being a more cosmopolitan place, would incorporate all influences and create different styles.
Rio de Janeiro was very different to Bahia. It was then a rapidly expanding city of some 500,000, with a large white population boosted by new immigrants, not just from Portugal, but from Germany, Italy, and Spain. They looked to white Europe, and certainly not Africa, as the model for their lifestyle and culture. But then this South American port had once been declared a European capital. In 1808, the entire Portuguese court had moved to Rio from Lisbon, fearing for their lives after Napoleon invaded Portugal. For the next 13 years, while the court remained, Rio became the capital, not just of Brazil, but of Portugal and the Portuguese Empire. The courtiers who moved to Rio brought with them Portuguese musical styles, like the Modinha.
Modinha is so near the heart of Brazilian music, and it's a song. It's a kind of song. It was developed in the Portuguese court by a mad monk, an intensely erotic priest who wanted to use song to seduce young girls. So he adapted folk forms and court poetry to a kind of fusion in which you could express a range of very tender sentiments. It became so popular in the cities like Salvador and Rio that every night the young men out serenading, you could just hear the sounds everywhere in the street.
In Rio, African rhythms began to mix with European styles. And it was at the house of a candomblé practitioner, a priestess named Tia Ciata, Auntie Ciata, that the first song widely recognized as carioca samba, Samba from Rio, was performed in 1916. It was credited to a musician named Donga and titled Pelo Telefone, on the telephone.
Donga cantou pelo telefone. O chefe da polícia pelo telefone mandou me avisar que na Carioca tem uma roleta para se jogar, uma coisa muito conhecida. E disse, samba é isso.
E na casa de Tia Ciata é que se reuniam, né, os grandes compositores. Né? Quer dizer, Donga, que faz o primeiro samba, que é o pelo telefone, João da Baiana, o Pixinguinha. Né? Essas pessoas todas ficavam sempre na casa de Tia Ciata, que era uma casa que tinha batuque, roda de samba, boas comidas.
Tia Ciata's house in Praça 11 was the center both for samba musicians and those who specialized in an urban instrumental style that became the first Brazilian music to become popular in Europe. Choro was a mixture of Afro-Brazilian rhythms and European dance styles and sounded like Brazil's answer to New Orleans jazz. The finest choro exponent, also famed for his samba playing, was the composer and flute player Pixinguinha.
There's a wonderful saying in Brazil that if you want to write about Brazilian folk music, you're going to have to write many volumes. But if you want to sum it all up in one word, it's Pixinguinha.
Para nós, né, para mim em especial, Pixinguinha foi o maior músico brasileiro, não é? O que ele representa para nós foi uma coisa realmente fantástica.